Hi, I'm Matt, the in-house Snowcrash-ologist here at Red Pepper, and welcome to another edition of Touch on Tech, where we cover the latest in emerging technologies so we can share it with you.
Reality is a lie.
So would you spend 500 ETH, which translates to $1.5 million on a Coca-Cola puffer jacket, just so you could wear it in the metaverse? Well, you can do that now. Coca-Cola has released their own set of NFTs, one of one, which means only one person can ever own them, and they are putting them out for people to buy. So what would you ever do with these digital clothes? Well, you can take them on over to Decentraland, and you can wear them there. You can hop around in your little Coca-Cola puffer jacket and be like, yep, I spent $1.5 million on this. Pretty cool. And speaking of owning brands in the metaverse, if puffer jackets aren't your thing, well, maybe a branded digital horse is. Stella Artois is gonna sell some of those ZED RUN horses, then they're gonna be branded with Stella designs. Getting ready to get PETA all up on them because they're branding horses. It hurts their butts. And how much does one of these Stella Artois horses go for? Well, you can get Lunetti's for $51,000. And maybe it'll actually make that money back for you as it races. Speaking of digital objects, Snap has released a plugin that allows the spectacles, which are those augmented reality glasses that overlay digital content onto the real world, it allows them to actually bring t-shirts and all types of clothes to life. So you don't have to have a plain, boring, normal shirt. These glasses will actually make that shirt interactive. So maybe you're walking down the street and somebody's wearing a Pepsi outfit and you say, now I want them to wear a Coca-Cola branded puffer jacket. Boom. Now, bye-bye, Pepsi. So what's more is you can turn these digital wearables into NFTs. And then eventually you're gonna need a place to store all these NFT wearables. And then how are you gonna pick which one you wanna wear? You're not gonna walk into a closet, open a door, pick out a shirt. You just walk into the room and you're surrounded by shoes. You're surrounded by shirts. You can pick this little polo out. I think I'll wear green today. Yep, what's that I hear? Is that an AI? Time to head to the bunker. All right, now that we're in here safe away from those AIs, let me tell you a little something. OpenAI, which has created one of our favorite tools, GPT-3, which is the text generation AI that can make it sound like a real human is typing these words, has released Codex, which is their text-to-code tool. Now, what does it do? You simply just tell it what you want. You say, I'm gonna need a game of a little person and a boulder. And I need that boulder to drop on the person. The whole time it's coding what you need to actually create this thing. And so then you can tell it, oh, by the way, if the rock hits the human, say ouch and say, hope you do better next time. Try again. And the game writes itself. Now the AI has learned to drop boulders on people. Not the best thing to teach them. Great. Well, that's it for another edition of Touch on Tech. Thanks for coming by and spending some time with us. And we hope to see you next time on another edition of Touch on Tech.
Be back.